In all considerations of Harikatha, there are two considerations or measurements, whether it's acceptable or whether it's bona fide or correct. And that was spoken by through Damodar and Nanti Lila of Chaitanya Charitamrita. So I was mentioning that what I was just saying about my understanding, it's my idea only, of the how Radha and Krishna received, they're oftentimes called Gandharvika Giridhari. And as I mentioned, I couldn't recall specific shlokas or maybe even prayers where these two names are glorified in relation to Radha and Krishna. There must be there, but I can't recall just now. But when we do speak or we read, we are guided by this principle that Lord Chaitanya decided what to listen to and what to reject or what to not listen to. Someone, when he was living in Puri, being a famous pundit from Navadvip, Nimai Pandit, now he's a sannyasi, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Many Brahmins, because he's a Brahmin, he's surrounded by Brahmins, he's a big pundit. So many Brahmins would come there to show them their poetry, to show them their songs or poems or essays or books or whatever they would write, because they thought if he likes it or if he approves of it, then I can tell people, oh, I showed it to Nimai Pandit, I showed it and he liked it. So he would, Sarup Damodar, or maybe Damodar Pandit, I'm not sure, I think Sarup Damodar, he would, first he would listen. That's like Lalita Sakhi. She, before Radharani gets anything, it goes through Lalita's hand. So Lalita, Sarup Damodar, he would read it first, or he would listen to it, and he would decide whether it was acceptable, whether we could offer it, or read it to, or speak it to Lord Chaitanya. And the two criterion for what was acceptable or rejectable was based on Siddhanta and Rasa.